Hi guys, welcome to my channel, I'm John. Today we are going to remake the abstract AI face animation in Blender 3D 3.0 using Geometry Node's Fill Workflow. Okay, first, before we jump into Geometry Node, we need to design our instant object. So select the default cube, press N to toggle the transform panel, change the dimension to 0.2 for X and Y axis, 0.25 for Z axis. Then press Ctrl A and apply the scale. Go into edit mode, press 3 to switch the selection mode to face select, or you can press here, select this face, then press Shift S and select cursor to selected. Exit edit mode, go to object and set origin to 3D cursor. Okay, then press Shift S and move the cursor to world origin. Duplicate the cube. Select this cube, go into edit mode, and then we can start to make some simple design on top of the cube. Switch the selection mode to face select. Select this face, press I to insert faces. Let's put 0.04 for the thickness. Press E to extrude it. Press numpad 3 to see the side view. Press alternate G to turn on the X-ray mode. Move it slightly higher. Then press Tab to exit the edit mode. Press Shift A and add another cube. Make it smaller. Apply the scale. Then move it higher. Press alternate G again to off the X-ray mode. Okay, then let's add a material to this cube. Add a material to this cube as well. Then select two of these, press Ctrl J to join it. Select both of them, press M and add them into a new collection. Let's name it Instant Object. Press OK, then we can hide them. Okay, next, we can start to create the face using Geometry Nodes. Press Shift A and add a plane. Resize the plane to 30m by 30m, then press Ctrl A and apply the scale. Then split the screen and go to Geometry Node Editor. Click New to apply Geometry Node to the plane, pin it. Okay, now we need to clone the instant object on the plane. So let's add an instant on point node. Now the plane is disappear. To show the plane, we need to add a joint geometry. Then connect the geometry from group input to the joint geometry. Then drag the instant object collection into the geometry node editor. Take separate children, reset children, and pick instant. Then connect the geometry to the instant. Okay, then we need to subdivide the plane. So add a subdivide mesh and put it before the instant on point node. Increase the level to 7. Okay, now I want to randomize the arrangement of the instant object. So let's add a random value. Change this to integer. Connect it to instant index. Then play with the seed value to randomize it. 9 is good for me. And then we can start to add our texture map into the geometry nodes. And now connect the vector here to the group input. Then connect the color to the scale. Go to modifier properties, click this button, and then select UV map. Then go back to the image texture, click open. So what I have here is a depth map. So what it does is, it actually reflects the human face with just black and white. So the white point is represent the position that is closer to camera, and the darker area is further from camera. So you can actually download this image in the description below. So let's open the image. Okay, now we can see the depth map has affected the instant object. The deeper color on the depth map make the instant object smaller, and the brighter color area make the instant object bigger. And now, I only want the depth map to affect the z-axis. So to do it, let's add a combined XYZ before the instant on point node. Connect the image texture to the z-axis, then change the X and Y axis to 1. Okay, now the effect is not obvious enough. So let's add a math node before the combined XYZ. Change the function to multiply add, then let's multiply 20 You can try to multiply other numbers as well to get a different result. Okay, next, we can start animate it. So what I'm going to do is, I want to set up an empty sphere as a controller to control the animation. The instant object that touched by the empty sphere will be taller, and the instant object outside of the empty sphere will be shorter. Okay, to do it, select the collection and add an empty sphere. Make it bigger, then let's name it controller. Drag it into the geometry node editor. So when the empty sphere touches the instant object, in order to make the instant object smaller or bigger, we need to have two sets of data, which is a maximum size of the instant object and a minimum size of the instant object. So here, we already have our maximum size. So select two of this node, press Ctrl+J to frame it, then press F2 and name it maximum size. Then for the minimum size, let's simply add a value node. Press Ctrl+J to frame it, press F2 and name it minimum size. Then we need to add a mixed RGB node to mix the minimum and maximum size together. Connect the minimum size to the mixed RGB, connect it to the color 1. So later when we finish set up everything, the instant object that touched by the empty sphere will trigger the data of maximum size here. Then the instant object that not touched by the empty sphere will trigger the value for minimum size here. So now, if we play with the factor, when we slide the factor to left, it will trigger the minimum size. And if we push it to right, it will trigger the maximum size here. And now, I want to make the empty sphere to affect the factor of the mixed RGB. So to do it, we need to let Blender know the position of the instant object and the location of the empty sphere. So let's add a position node. We need to get the position of the instant object. Then add a vector math node. Change the operation to distance. Then connect the position and the location of the empty sphere to the vector math node. Then connect the vector math node to the factor of mixed RGB. And now if we move the controller, we can see the empty sphere is start to affect the instant object. And next, I want to make the scale of the empty sphere to affect the instant object as well. So let's add a map range after the vector math node. Connect the scale of empty sphere to the from max, then change the to minimum to 1 and to maximum to 0. Then change this to smoother step. So now we can see the instant object inside the empty sphere is taller and the instant object outside of the empty sphere is shorter. I think we can increase the minimum size to 0.2 so that it looks nicer. Then next, we can start to animate the empty sphere controller. So select the controller, go to output properties, change the frame start to 0 and the frame rate to 30 frames per second. Drag the time indicator to 0. Scale the empty sphere smaller. Then add a keyframe. Press this button to jump to last frame. Make the empty sphere bigger until it covers the entire plane. Then add a keyframe again. Okay, then drag the time indicator to check the animation. Okay, next, I want to add some ripple effect to the animation. So to do it, we need to add the color ramp after the map range. Let's add another two color. Change this to white. This one to black. Then change this to east. Now let's drag the time indicator again to check the animation. Okay, everything looks good. So if you want to add more ripple, you can add more color to the color ramp. Okay, next, we can add lighting and set up the camera to finish the scene. Press this button to jump to the end frame, select the camera, then press Ctrl Alternate Numpad 0 to frame the view you are looking at. Let's adjust the position a little bit, and the rotation as well. Then go to the camera properties tab, change the focal length to 120. I think we can make the plane bigger. I want it to cover the entire scene. Apply the scale. Then we need to make the AI face smaller. So press tab to go into edit mode. go to the UV editor. In the UV editor, press A to select the map and then scale it bigger. Then press Tab again to exit the edit mode. Okay, then we can start to add lighting. So let's delete the existing lighting. Then add an area light. Move it higher. Go to the render properties, change the render engine to cycle, change the device to GPU, turn on the render preview. Go to the world properties tab, change the color to blue color. Then select the area light, go to the light properties tab, change the power to 1200, increase the size to 2 meters. So the larger the size, the softer shadow we get. Then press Shift D and followed by X to duplicate the area light. Let's increase the power to 2000. Okay, now I want to add some decorative object beside the AI face. So to do it, let's add a plane in 3D viewport. Make it bigger. Put 60 maybe. Apply the scale. Then go back to the geometry node editor. Unpin it. Add a new geometry node to the plane. Add distribute point on face. Then add instant on point node. Then add a cube and connect it to instant. Then now the cube are all overlapping together. So let's reduce the point on the plane. Make the cube bigger. Then I want to randomize the size of the cube. Okay, then I want to add boolean and make some hole on the cube. So let's duplicate the distribute point on face and put it after the cube. Then add instant on point node. Duplicate the cube and connect it to instant. Okay, then add a mesh boolean after the instant on point node. Connect this cube to the mesh boolean. Make this cube smaller. Then increase the density factor to 1. Okay, now I want to randomize the size of the hole. So let's duplicate the random value. Connect it to the instant on point node. Increase the maximum size to 4. Okay, then let's add a material to the decorative object. Go to the group output. Add the set material node. Then in the material column, select this material. Okay, now we done it. So if you like my video, please subscribe and see you in the next video. Bye.